To install WSL2, search for Turn Windows Features On or Off. Scroll down to Virtual Machine Platform and tick the box. Select the Windows subsystem for Linux, check the box and click OK. Windows Features will prompt you to restart your computer. Click Restart Now. After the computer has rebooted, open Command Prompt with administrator privileges and type in wsl-set-default-version2 to set default version of WSL to WSL2. This must be done before installing any Linux distribution. Type wsl-list-online to see the distributions. Type wsl-install-d Ubuntu to install Ubuntu. This will open another command prompt controlling Ubuntu. Type in a new username and confirm the password you entered. After you have installed WSL2, just upgrade it. I've put all the commands in the description. Check if Git and Python is available just by typing the command git and python 3. You can exit the Python interpreter with exit and the brackets. Go into the internet and search for the Vlad Automatic. And in the description there will be the install link. Just copy it and paste it into the WSL2 prompt. Install the Python 3 virtual environment, and if it prompts you, just hit yes. And you may need pip, so install it too. After you have cloned the automatic repository, it will show the automatic directory, and change the directory into it and launch the web UI. And it may fail on the first try, and it will also show no signs of any progress. So you can check the task manager and your Ethernet connectivity and see that it downloads something. So this is how I check if it's doing something. After it has downloaded all, it will continue doing something, and it may fail. For me, it failed at server arguments. And I solved that by removing the virtual environment and adding it again. Be very careful with the rm-rf command and only use it with the venv directory. And I think I was missing another library, and indeed I was missing it. It is the libgl1 library, and it crashes somehow if this isn't there. And I installed it. As I said, all the commands are in the description. And when I executed the web UI again, it somehow didn't prompt me to download the default model, and it ran into an error because of that. So I just restarted my machine. You can also just terminate the Ubuntu WSL2 machine with WSL2-t Ubuntu and check if it's running with list verbose. And after I've done that, I've just restarted the web UI and it prompted me, and I could hit yes. So it downloaded the default model. Here, as you can see, I could type yes. And it will look something like this when it's working. And you can paste the local URL. It shows it in the output of the command prompt, and you can paste it and prompt it for something. I've just did this so I can see if it actually is working. And if you go to the WSL2 prompt, you see the progress. If you are not sure if it's using your GPU, you can check in the task manager and see the utilization is at 100% currently. I want to show you how to increase the RAM and the swap file size for the WSL. You can do this with going to the home path, and I have a WSL config file there. I recommend turning on the file extensions, because for this file, just create a text file, remove the file extension, call it .wslconfig. And you can put some parameters in there, the RAM and the swap size. And it must look exactly like I type it there, otherwise it won't work. So these are the square brackets and WSL2. And then I put the memory and set it to 5 gigabytes. And I've put a swap size, file size, because I noticed that it just doesn't work. It doesn't load the model. Somehow I don't have enough RAM. So I put the file size to 12 gigabytes and it worked this way. And just put this file in the home path. Restart your whole PC. Well, it doesn't work when you restart or when you terminate. Just WSL2 somehow doesn't work. So I'll restart my PC afterwards. And now for two quality of life improvements. If you have Vlad Automatic and Automatica 1111, you will need to download the models every time for every web UI. And they take a lot of space, as you can see. And if you have multiple, you may have like 50 gigabytes of models. So I put them all in a central place. To demonstrate, I've put them to the desktop file location, and you can create a link in Linux. The link just links to a file somewhere else on the hard disk, and you can also put this on some remote server, which is really useful, especially if you have like a home server or something. So I just navigate back into the desktop and copy the file path, so C colon and user, and I go into the Linux prompt and navigate just for fun to the automatic directory. But you can do this anywhere you want. You can create a link with ln and then dash s and just put the mount location, the mount, so the Windows file system is mounted on mount slash c. Just put the location there where your model file is, and then put the model file location on the Linux hard disk. So it's an automatic model slash stable diffusion. And you can do this for all the models. It's really useful because you can save a lot of space, especially if you have tons of models. And I just want to demonstrate that this actually works by launching the web UI. And then you can see it calculated the model hash. So it has definitely recognized it and it works. In the stable diffusion folder, there will just be a file called desktop, which is the link. I want to show you another quality of life improvement. For that, I will terminate Ubuntu, and you currently have a golden image because you have done nothing on the machine and it just works. So that's perfect. I will export it. If you have a friend, or if somehow the Linux machine gets messed up and it doesn't work anymore, you can just import this backup. So it works with this command wsl dash dash export and then Ubuntu and then the machine and the file name. I will use this unregister command to delete the currently installed Ubuntu machine. Don't use this command if you have not exported it, because this will delete all the files. But you see I have on the desktop the backup. That's useful because you can install it centrally, and as I said, you can give it to a friend or someone. I like to keep all my WSL machines on one central location. For me, that's the C colon drive. I just create some folders. And to import the backup, just WSL dash dash import Ubuntu, and yeah, specify the path where you want to import it, and specify the backup location file, the file location of the backup. And that's it. It will create a file that may take some minutes, because I think this was 13.1 gigabytes. So you can see that it extracts the file, and you see the file size increases. I want to show you that this actually works by now starting Ubuntu, and you will see you will be root on the machine, and you can sudo su into your local user account. So the prompt looks exactly the same like before, and you can see the automatic folder is there still, and you can execute the web environment as before. And I just want to show you that you can now delete the backup and it still works, because of course it has extracted the backup into the husk, the hard disk image. So I will now you can actually just F5 this site, but I've pasted the link again. And if you prompt it for something, it will start initializing and start the generation. These are the two quality of life improvements I wanted to show you, because you can save a lot of space and a lot of hassle if it doesn't work and you need to reinstall it, and that takes a lot of time. That's it for this video. If you have a question, comment it. Bye.